Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about the plane mirror. See, what is a plane mirror? In your house, you have seen the mirrors which are attached on your cupboards, or the mirrors which you use to see yourself in. Okay, that are the plane mirrors. Okay, that are the mirrors. So actually, what is the mirror? First, we will start from here. We will see the reflection of plane mirror. So what is the plane mirror? Have you ever seen? Now mirror, you have seen a small piece of mirror. If you have seen how it is, it has two coverings. On one side you can see it is highly polished, and on other side you can see a coating which is given to the polished surface. Okay, means one side it is a pure polished, highly polished glass it is, and behind that a silver coating is given to that glass. Okay, so when the coating is given, what happens? Now it has become a plane mirror, okay, which we are using in our daily life. So what happens over here? When the light falls on the highly polished surface of the plane mirror, what happens? The light which falls on the plane mirror, it is reflected by the polished silver surface. Okay, the coating which is given to the mirror, that is used to reflect the light. Okay, silver surface. Why silver surface? Can you tell why only silver surface is given as coating to the mirrors? Everywhere you can see the mirrors are silver only, white coating is there so that you can see yourself clearly. But why silver? Okay, for your understanding, I can tell you one thing, that if you take a plain glass, okay, so it has only 4% of light is reflected. Without coating glass, if you will take, it has only 4% of it reflects only 4% of light behind. And if you will see here, clear glass reflects only 4% of reflected light, and whereas if you will take a polished aluminium or silver surface, it has the ability to reflect 90% of light. Okay, that's why here silver surface is used, because silver has the ability to reflect 90% of the light. Okay, until now there is no any material which reflects 100% light. Okay, so most reflected light is given by the silver surface. That's why it is used in the mirrors, plate mirrors. So what happened? Light strikes the polished surface, and the coated surface, the coated silver surface reflects the light back. Okay, so this is how reflection takes place in the plane mirror. Actually, what happens, we are going to study here how the everything you are going to study, how the images form, everything about plane mirror you will study today. Okay, which type of images form, what is image, that we will study now. Now every day you are seeing your face in the mirror. Have you ever thought that how we can see in this mirror? Okay, how the images form, how you can see yourself in the mirror? Actually, what happened? The light in your house falls on you, your body, and it falls on the mirror. Okay, and that the light which falls on the mirror, that reflects back to your eyes, and you are able to see yourself in the mirror. Okay, now see, what is the image? When you see yourself in the mirror, that is your image. Okay, as you are looking, same it is shown in the mirror. The whatever part you are seeing in the mirror, that is your image. Okay, so what is the definition of image? It is the impression of the object. Means when you are standing in front of your mirror, you are the object, and what you are seeing, that is the image of yourself. So impression of an object carried over and formed by light reflected over it. So what it is actually? It is formed by the light reflected on it. Okay, how the image is formed? It is our impression, and it is formed because of the reflected light on the mirror, which makes an image. Okay, now this is the image. Now images, as you know, two types of image. There are real image and virtual image. So first we will see what is the real image. The real image is said to be real when it is said real. See, before going to this topic, I just want to tell you that this topic is for 10th standard also. Okay, so you have a good opportunity to clear your concept here only, so that it will be very easy for you in the 10th standard. Okay, all this concept you are going to study again in the 10th standard. Okay, so please clear your concept here only, because all these are the very important and basic concepts of light. What is real image? What is virtual image? Some students cannot imagine this. Okay, it is very difficult for some students to imagine what is virtual, what is real. Actually, these are the very simple things. Okay. So just try to concentrate and listen here. An image is said to be real image if it can be caught on the screen. Now you have listened, real image, virtual image. Real image is the image which can be caught on the screen. For example, you are taking your photo. Your photo is captured in the screen. So it is a real image. Okay, now here you can see me in the video. Okay, so this is also a real image, because the camera has caught my image in it. Okay, so this is a real image, the image which can be caught in the plane mirror. Can you catch your image in the plane mirror? If you are standing in the plane mirror, can you catch your image and keep? No, you cannot do that. Okay, so a very simple concept. What is real image? Real image is the image which can be captured. Okay, that is the real image. For example, image on the screen in a theater. Okay, on the theater you can see the image. That, and very simple example, you are seeing me in front of your screen. That is also a real image. Okay. Now, what is virtual image? A image is said to be virtual. Now, here you have to think, what is virtual? Virtual means you can see the image, but you cannot capture it. You can just see it for a while, but you cannot capture it. Okay, that is a virtual image. Understood? For example, if you see, you can see yourself in the water, plain water, you can see yourself, your image you can see sometimes. Can you capture that and keep? No, you cannot. Okay, so all these images are the virtual images. So here example is image observed in the plane mirror. Whatever you are seeing every day, you are seeing yourself in the plane mirror, that is a virtual image. Understood the difference between real image and virtual image? Because all this concept you need for forward for diagrams and all. Okay, for conditions you all need this. So here please clear your doubt for real and virtual image. Understood? Now here I am going to explain you about the image formed on the plane mirror. How the image is formed, I will explain you. Here you can see a candle. Okay, this is a mirror, and the shaded part shows the silver coating. Means the front side of the mirror is this side, and this lines which I have shaded here, that is the behind part of the mirror. Means the mirror is placed like this. This is the main reflecting surface. This is the candle, and this is the image formed by the mirror. Okay, now here you can see that this is the object, and what you are, which image you want to take, you are going to take the images of the image of this flame. Okay, now here we are supposing that light is coming out. Yesterday I have told you one concept, convergent rays and divergent rays. Okay, convergent means all rays which comes at one point, diverge means which go out from one point. Here you can see from this flame the rays are coming out, means they are diverging out. Okay, these are the divergent rays which falls on the mirror and it reflects back. You can see, as I have told you, no one cannot reflect 100%. Okay, so this rays fall on the mirror and you can see it reflects back. Some mirror is reflected back, and what we have done, you can see at the point of incidence, what we have done, we have extended it back to the mirror. Here all rays which you can see, we have extended this. You can see it has incident and it has reflected, and it is extended behind. All the four rays which I have drawn here, I have extended back, and from the extended back rays you can see they have meet at one point. Okay, means they have converged at one point, and at that point you can see the image. If you will see the distance between the image and the mirror, it is equal to the distance of mirror and image. Okay, very simple concept. If you are standing in front of your plane mirror, what happens over there? You can see as you are standing, similarly you can see in front of your in front of the mirror you can see. Okay, if you will go back behind, what you can see? If you are going behind, you can see that your image is becoming small. Okay, and if you are little bit, if you are standing here, you can see as you are same size image you can see in the mirror. But if you are going behind, you can see your mirror image is becoming small. Means something is happening inside the mirror. What is happening? Nothing. Just the differ. It differs the size. If you are going far away from the mirror, your size is becoming less. If you are coming, if you are at the equal distance, means if you are standing 5 meters away from the mirror, your image is also formed 5 meter behind the mirror. Okay, actually many students will think limited mirror, but how image will form behind? Okay, because the coating is there. The coating is there inside the coating. What happens? It reflects it inside the mirror. What happens? The image is formed. And how it show? The images show the difference. How whatever we are doing, you can see. If you will move behind, it will certainly show small. If you will stand in front with equal distance, you can see equal images form on the surface, means the coated part. That's why what we are doing, we are just extending the reflected ray. Okay, we are extending the reflected ray. Suppose this candle I have kept this much far away, the ray will come and it will fall on the surface, it will reflect it back. Same we are going to extend, and if it is this much distance apart, you will get the image also this much distance apart. Means this depends, size distance depends over here. Okay, it matters over here. Understood? Now this is how the from an object images occurred, or we have formed an image over here. You can see here the light rays actually do not actually come from the point. Okay, they do not actually come from the point. What happened? We have extended it. That's why it is called as virtual image. Here I have told you one idea to find out virtual and real image. Here is another idea how to find the real and virtual image. This is another concept how to find whether the image is real or virtual. Actually, which type of image is this? This is virtual. Why it is virtual? Because these lines are virtual. You can see the lines which we have extended. That is not proper. That is what we have, imaginary lines we have created, and it is virtual. Okay, that's why this which we have founded, it is the virtual image. That's why it is called as virtual. Here only the light falls here, it reflects back. But what we are doing, we are virtually or we are imaginarily, we are extending it behind. So here the image forms is a virtual image. Okay, and opposite to this real image, what happens in the real image? All the point converge at one point, means all these rays come and meet at one point, and there are images formed. It is a real image because what happens here, all ray comes at one point, they meet at one point, and they form an image at one point, and that all rays are real rays. Okay, there is no any imaginary drawn over here, and that is called as real image. Okay, this is how, this is the second type, how second concept, how you can find the real and virtual images. Okay, and see, this is a very important point. Size of the image is same as size of the object in front. As I have explained you, if you are standing in the front of the mirror, size of the image will be same as the size of the object if you are standing in front. Okay, I hope you all have understood this concept. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, thank you.